Hey guys, I'm Phil Martin. I'm a portrait photographer located right here in Washington, D.C.
So hi, my name is James Jackson. I'm a photographer. I've lived in Washington, D.C. for almost 9 years now.
A little about me is that I'm on the autism spectrum, and the way that affects me is through communication and personal connections with people. So portrait photography allows me to connect with people on a more intimate level that is hard for me to do on a regular basis. Towards the beginning of my career in photography, my mother got really sick. And so during the last few weeks of her life, I documented it through photography because that was my way of coping at that time. And those images were so well received by people across the world. And so many people reached out to me about how those images helped them feel like they weren't alone. It helped them feel as if, you know, they were seen because they were going through similar things. So because of that is why I began to want to tell stories through portraiture. My biggest fear when it comes to photography, kind of relates to me being on the autism spectrum. There are often times where I'm in settings where I'm around a lot of people and I'm shooting a major event, and because of everything going on around me, I start to feel that anxiety and that panic, and you know, all those effects of autism start to pile on. But I kind of have to take a moment, center myself, and remember that this shot that I'm going to shoot might be powerful. It might inspire other people on the autism spectrum to overcome their fears, and it helps me get through. So sometimes you're going to be in situations where you're uncomfortable and where you're nervous and where you're scared, but you have to remember that what you capture with your camera might inspire and help somebody else overcome the same thing.
I mainly do editorial portraiture and hospitality photography. So like I work with a lot of hotels. The reasons that I like doing those, I don't care for just like headshots or like school picture type of portraits. I like portraits where there's some context around the person and it helps you understand more about that person based on the environment that they're in. As far as finding my voice as an artist, I think I'm still doing that. And I think if I ever thought I had that figured out, I would probably quit. Because I think if I thought I had photography figured out and knew exactly how to express my point of view, then it would be boring. And I don't think I would want to do it. I typically use Sony cameras. I enjoy them the best, but I've absolutely sold iPhone photos to clients as well. The best camera is the one that you have with you, you know, and at the end of the day, if the photo looks good, the client doesn't really care what sort of equipment you use to take the photo, you know. Like if I build you a dining room table, you're not going to care if I used like a manual saw or an electric saw as long as the table is pretty. It's the same with photography. Taking portraits of people actually makes me really nervous because people have opinions about the way they look. They want to be perceived in a certain way. So taking portraits of people actually makes me really uncomfortable on the inside. People say that I'm good at putting folks at ease when they're in front of my camera. So I guess it doesn't show. The fact that it makes me uncomfortable is probably good, right? Because that means that I'm pushing my creativity and I'm pushing myself to learn more and to do more and to try more. I think that if you just sit in your comfort zone and only do what's comfortable, that you're probably not going to grow as an artist.